Hello everyone! Today we make a quiche!
Hey ho! Today we're making a quiche. It's a tart-based savory dish made on a crust pastry filled with everything what you want. The basic one is a quiche Lorraine with a bacon and onion. I'm gonna make a fusion version, add some spices and tomatoes because it tastes better. We're starting with making a base, which we have to bake before we add the rest of the wet ingredients. The recipe is very simple. You just have to, for one tart, you can make like 300 gram of flour, plain flour, and 150 gram of butter. Just short crust pastry. This one is good enough for 24 centimeters mold. Just 300 of flour and 150 of butter, salt, and that's it. Just knead everything good, use your hands. After that, very thinly use a roller pin and roll everything. Make a base a little bit bigger than the mold, because remember about the edges. Even if you have a crack on the edge, if you have some leftovers, just fill it with this leftover. We have to bake this first, and to bake this, we don't want to puff the pastry. We have to put some baking paper and on the top bake this with a bean, or you can buy it in any store, special stones for a baking. You make some holes, a lot of holes, because you need more air inside the crust pastry to bake evenly everywhere. Okay, oven 200 degrees, about 10 minutes, check. Now we have time for making our filling for this quiche. Basically, it's a quiche Lorraine plus some extra ingredients I liked more. We start with the onion, chopped and fry very gently. We need a soft, sweet onion, not fried. Of course, my favorite garlic, adding garlic almost for everything I can. After the garlic, we need about 250 gram of bacon. We can use the slices like rashers or anything like that, but for a quiche, you don't need any fancy kind of bacon. You can even buy cooking bacon, something like I bought. It's a trimmings of bacon, gammon and everything else. Just cut this in small pieces. We still have to fry everything. It tastes even better because you have lots of different textures from many kinds of bacon you have. When you start frying your bacon, try to start from the very low heat to melt down as much as possible fat from the bacon. Try to not fry them too quick, because they're gonna be very hard. You can even simmer the bacon for the first stages using a lid. You're gonna cook it a little bit, but you're gonna have much more fat. When everything is frying, we have time to make our egg and cream base. You just take 5 eggs, mash them, whisk everything, add cream, whisk it again, add some mustard, any herbs you want, any spices, of course cheese and everything. This is the moment when you're making a flavor of this dish. Okay, bacon is almost done. We have loads of fat, it's golden crispy. We gonna use the same fat plus a little bit more of oil to simmer our onion. Make golden brown, the same, use lid very slowly, gently. We don't need a frying one, we just need a nice soft sweet onion. Okay, we have now our base ready, the first stage. Now we can bake it again for another 5 minutes without beans. Back to our onion is ready, soft, not brown. It's best time to start filling our tart. On the bottom we're gonna put our onions everywhere, we'll spread it around. On the top of that we're gonna put our bacon, spread gently everywhere. On the top of that we can put our tomatoes, cocktail tomatoes, and everything else what we want more. And when we put all the hard ingredients, we can put our wet ingredients like our sauce and cheese. On the top of our sauce we put extra cheese, and voila, now it's back to the oven for another 20 minutes, 200 degrees, just golden brown on the top. It should be beautiful. Now just cut in couple pieces, put this on your plate. Oh yeah, I found some chives in my garden. Yeah, we can spread this on the top of our quiche. And voila!